Okay, so that was a great start to the day. We were supposed to get a delivery between 8 in the morning and 6 at night, but already had the delivery at 9 in the morning. So these are the aluminium or aluminum scaffolding tubes and these connecting pieces. They will be used to create the bed, and we have seen them used in every type of furniture that you can imagine indoors, but we haven't seen them used in a van yet. And yeah, we'd like to show you how we build our bed using these scaffolding tubes, and yeah, we're very excited to share it with you and hope that some of you might use the idea as well. So yeah, let's get started. So in houses, people often use the steel variety of these scaffolding tubes, and the connecting pieces that we have are steel as well, but we went for aluminum tubes because they are much more lightweight. We didn't buy the aluminum connecting pieces because they're so incredibly expensive. It would have cost at least I think 150 euros extra, perhaps even more. So that's just too much, but the total of weight that we will be adding using this bed is I think 31 kilograms, so that would be around 65 pounds. It's quite a lot, but I think we would have ended up at the same weight using wood, and this will just be much more user-friendly, and it's also I think a nice sight and a little bit different. So yeah, if you want to build this and you have unlimited budget or something like that, then you should definitely go for the aluminum brackets as well. But yeah, we couldn't afford that at the moment. So yeah.
So here you see the difference. The steel pieces are quite matte and they look quite rustic and industrial. We really like that look. And here we have these shiny aluminum tubes. Yeah, I really like the look of both of them. These shiny tubes, however, are very easily scratched. So yeah, we'll see. Might not look as sleek after we've installed them, but yeah, that's alright. So Jordi has just started and he's connected these leg holders to these scaffolding tubes. Basically just twisting a bolt that comes in these brackets or legs. You can just twist it and that will keep the leg in place. It's very simple, so you don't have to drill a hole. It just squeezes the aluminum and then it stays in place. We will probably have to cut some of these tubes because Jordi ordered them specifically a bit tad too long, because it's difficult to calculate how much of the tube exactly goes into such a bracket, so you don't exactly know how long of a distance it will cover with a bracket on either end. And we were only able to order it per each centimeter, so approximately like half an inch. So, and since we will like to use every single millimeter, we might have to cut off just a small piece. So yeah, you already ordered some of them a bit too long on purpose, so we can make the most of it basically. I don't know if you remember this drawing. I showed it a couple of videos ago, and that was our bed frame idea. And we just built the outer frame. So here we have the fixed part, which is this here. And here we have the tube on the side, which is this part. So this here is still loose on each end, so once we finish building the part that goes in the middle here that has to be moved on there, we can decide where this goes and we can fix it into place. But other than that, the main structure is finished now, and the crate is also in place, and we will leave it here because we will add another leg right where Jordi's hand is, and that will make sure that the crate is fully in place because this leg is in front. One leg will be behind it, and then we also keep it in place with the wheelbase structure there.
Okay, so we just realized that we are stupid because we have to add these connecting pieces to each tube that will hold the slatted base. So yeah, we can disconnect the entire thing. We knew that we would have to do it for these two, but we just put that tube in place and we can disconnect it now. But oh yeah, it's going quite smoothly, so can't complain. Okay, issue resolved. The brackets are on. So now you can see how we will connect a slatted base. That will be done in three pieces, one here, one there, and one in the separate area that can move back and forth. So these brackets are ideal if you want to connect a beam on either side, which we're going to do. Then we have ones over there and there. They have just one area with on one of these areas on one side. So those will be spread out over the entire tube all along here, and we will attach a wooden beam here, there, and in the other part as well, two beams, and then we will attach these slats on there. And we already have these slats at home. They were kindly given to us by someone, and we just have to cut them to size. Here we have the hook that will connect the separate part here to turn it into a bed or sofa, which will hook onto here, and we can take it off and then attach it here as well as here. Okay, so we just created these two pieces, one here and one at the other end there, and that contains two brackets that just that we can disassemble easily, and two pieces that will hold a tube that runs all the way back there as well as here, and we can just lift either end, which is connected by our tubes, and put it in here. So you already ordered these two tubes a bit too long, as you can see there. He did that on purpose because we didn't know how far these brackets would how far up these brackets a tube would go and how much room it would take. So we are just measuring off how much we have to take off, and then we can use the same tool that we used to shorten the other ones, shorten these and secure them with these brackets around them this time immediately. And then the main frame is done. So we just shortened two of these scaffolding tubes using an angle grinder. We had never used such a tool before, and it was quite difficult to use because, well, one, we don't have a workbench because we didn't want to invest in one if we didn't have to, because that would just be a shame. But yeah, cutting it on this wasn't too easy. It worked out with the two of us, but yeah, the tube moved back and forth a lot, so that's not as safe, so we definitely do not recommend doing that. And the edge of this tube didn't turn out as straight as we had hoped, but we didn't expect it to. It was quite frayed as well, so we had to file the edges, but that worked out all right. It's quite smooth, smooth enough. So that will make it more safe to disassemble it in the future if we want to somehow build a new van for some reason. But yeah, it looks all right. Guys, this is perfection! So as you can see, we are not experts by any means, but yeah, it works. And it just goes to show that anyone can build a camper van. So if you live in an apartment or yeah, can't build your van in a garage and don't have much tools or much money, it just goes to show that you really can do it. And please don't let that hold you back, because it didn't hold us back, and we're happy that we did continue with our idea. We don't have much, but it works. Guys, the bed frame is finished. I think we've been at it for 6 hours, so it took us quite a long time, and that's because for some reason we just had to cut off much more of each of these tubes than we expected, so every time we had to disconnect everything, take out a tube and measure it, but it looks great. We haven't connected these pieces yet. They will have to be measured tomorrow, and then we will connect those and put them in the correct area. And we have not connected those to the floor yet. We will bolt them in tomorrow as well, or perhaps even later. But yeah, the basic frame is done. So here's just one final overview of the bed frame in its sofa position, and those two tubes are connected to these long ones, and you can pick that out and hang it over there. Like we said, we did not yet connect any beams to these hooks, so these hooks are not into place yet either, and we don't have these slats cut up into size yet, but other than that, the frame is finished. Tomorrow we will work on bolting this to the floor, and we will also measure the mattresses out so we can order those as well, and I think we will then also work on the wardrobe and yeah, some other stuff. And if you guys do want a video on the bed once it's finished, in which we show every single part and how we assemble and disassemble it, and share with you all of the measurements and stuff like that, please do tell us. We've already received a few messages after sharing about this bed frame on Instagram. Yeah, we'd happily do so, and we would also write a blog post. But let us know, and then we will make one collected video in which we explain every single thing. But that's it for today, and yeah, I'm so happy with the result. It took us so long, but I think this is a very sturdy structure, and that's what we went for, and I think the look is great as well. So yeah, you will see more probably in tomorrow's vlog, or perhaps the day after, about how we continue building this bed, yeah, and that we make a start on the wardrobe as well, which will be difficult, but you'll see how that turns out. Okay, thanks for watching again. Bye!